the far north of North America, some time ago, there was a man, chief of his tribe, who had many daughters and many sons. There was one daughter whom he wasn't really very pleased with. He felt that she didn't come up quite to the standard he expected a chief's daughter should be. So he arranged for his young men to take her out on the kayak, onto the water, and not to bring her back. And because they were the young men and he was the chief, they did as he said. He asked her to come with them fishing duty. The men didn't usually go fishing, but she went. And they went to where the water is really choppy and rough. They cast the nets and they ask her to help, and then they kind of saw that she went over the edge and nobody helped her out. And so they arrived back without her. And if people knew or noticed or wondered, they didn't say. No one said anything. No one even mentioned her name ever again. It was quite taboo because he was chief. And so generations went past. And the whole of the customs of fishing changed, and there were trading posts now. But still the men at a certain time of year would go down and build themselves igloo kind of habitations down by the lake. And there was one fisherman who did this, and he bought himself a rod, a new fishing rod from a new trading post. He couldn't wait to try it out. So he was up down to the shore in his kayak, rowing out, and he cast his line into the choppy waters. Why he went there, I don't know. Maybe he thought the fish would be better there. Maybe he was feeling just kind of daring. Yeah, like taking a risk. It wasn't long before he got a catch. He was pulling at the line, and he pulled, and he pulled. And it was big, or it seemed to be big, and he really had to work hard to bring it in. And when eventually it popped up out of the waves, it was the head of a fish. It was the head of a human. It was covered in weeds and mud and slime. He couldn't really see exactly, but as he tried to shake it off and wind it and release it and wind it, it bobbed over the waves, and there were clearly arms, and they seemed to be waving at him. It was just like a woman waving, seeming pleased to be out of the water, because with all this mud and slime and seaweed, she looked like a woman who was following him on the end of the line. He couldn't shake her off. He was repulsive, but it was horrible. But he didn't want to lose his rod, so he fixed the rod in the boat, and he began to row fast back to the shore. Looking behind all the time, he looked behind. There was the woman, bouncing on the waves, waving, looking pleased ahead, and nodding up and down. The boat wedged itself on the shingle. He was out of the boat, grabbed his rod, running up the shore. Behind, bouncing now, almost seeming to take off on the end of the line, was the skeleton woman, waving, bouncing, following him. He was desperate. He ran fast to his home. He dived into the tunnel and crawled along. And he looked behind, and now the skeleton was all screwed up and tangled and in a terrible mess. It was just a big ball of weed and bones. And he got into his living space. And with his shaking hands, he lit the lamp. And the light flickered all around. And he went to the other side, threw the rod and this skeleton. He looked at it, trembling. He was repulsed. It was like nothing he'd ever seen. And the light began to fill the room and he could see it more clearly. But you know, there's a strange thing about things that really make you frightened, that make you feel repulsed. The more you look at them, the more interesting they get. And as time went on, maybe even an hour, he began to be curious. So he went over the ledge and started to peel off the weed, to remove some of the slime and the mud. And he could see the net. And then he began to disentangle the bones because there was a foot up through the pelvis and there was an arm through the ribcage. It was in such a mess. And he dragged it, wet and slimy, over towards the little fire and lamp. and he began to work on it. And it took him some time to sort it out. And he sang to himself while he was driving. You would see the ribcage of the skeleton woman begin to rise and fall, rise and fall. And gradually flesh appeared on bones, and eyes, and teeth, and nails, and hair. And it fleshed out with curls. And soon there were all of the parts and organs that made her a woman. And she sat up. And she looked over the man sleeping. And she went over. And you know, sometimes when you sleep, and you dream sad dreams, tears coming. And so it was that there were tears in his eyes, trickling down his cheeks, in his sleep. And she bent over and she drank his tears. She drank and drank. She was, oh, so thirsty. Then she got underneath the animal's skins and lay down beside him. And the two entwined and became one. And that was the beginning of good. And they stayed together for a lifetime. And if people wondered where this woman came from, if people thought maybe she looked like somebody else.